DC.
Thank you. I like DC. DC is gorgeous. The weather is just gorgeous right now. So pretty.
It's the Cherry Blossom Festival. Right?
It is, and I missed it by 3 days. Oh, well, I missed the Cherry Blossom by 3 days. The festival.
What was it like working with Robert?
He was, he's a man who knows exactly what he wants, yet to let you do your work. He's specific in what he wants, and if you get it for him immediately, it's on to the next season.
Since he's more of an actor's director, did you find that you were able to kind of have a little bit more leniency in your role?
I'll tell you, it made it a little more relaxing to work. Leniency, no, because he knows exactly what he wants to get out of you. But being an actor himself, he knows what process you're going through on the set and before you come.
And what compelled you to choose the role that you played?
He offered it to me. And I was thrilled about it because I love the story. I've known something about a couple of the conspirators in the story. Yet there are five or six others that I haven't heard of, and I don't think the general public has ever heard of. So it'll be a history lesson.
Did you study a lot about the history about the conspiracy?
Yeah, believe it or not, there's a lot online about John Lloyd, although he's probably the only one of the conspirators there's not a picture of. In the trial that there is not a picture of, but there it is photographically pretty much complete all the way down to the hanging.
And one last question, what can we expect to see you in next?
Well, I just finished Clint Eastwood's movie about young Edgar Hoover.
Oh, right here in D.C.
In D.C. Well, they shot some of it here. I shot a lot of mine in Los Angeles with Leo and a lot of other good people in here.
Great. Well, thanks for coming. I hope you enjoy your stay here
Thank
in D.C.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Thank you. All right.
I am one of the historical consultants.
What do you think Lincoln's greatest legacy? What do you think the legacy he's best known for to give to our country?
Well, I think the genius of Lincoln is that he transforms the Civil War into this struggle for freedom and puts us on the road to racial justice for people of color in this country. It's a major achievement, because prior to the Civil War, slavery was here to stay. But it's Lincoln who says, by the end of the Civil War, we can't have this institution anymore. So I think that's his greatest legacy. And that's why Americans, I think, see him as the greatest president.
And what do you think in his childhood most affected him to be the man that he was, to really recognize the value of bringing everybody together in one nation?
Well, you know, one of the reasons that we like Lincoln is that he's the quintessential American rags to riches story. You know, he only has 1 year at most of formal education. And yet, because he comes from these very humble beginnings,
Wanda, let me get the camera just in case.
Able to, I guess, understand the common man and goes all the way to the top. But, so I think you'd have to say that his humble origins, having had almost no formal education, but teaches himself to read and write and becomes a lawyer and then becomes the president, I think that probably explains that he has the empathy for people.
And what do you think his greatest struggle, the greatest struggle he had in his presidency, maybe aside from the northern and southern conflict?
Well, you know, he's a wartime president. He's elected, and his big struggle, I think, is the union. I suppose his biggest, he was determined to hold the union together, and probably the biggest struggle he had was the decision to forever end the institution of slavery by starting the Emancipation Proclamation and setting the country on the road to racial justice. So I think that was a tough decision.
And one last question for you. What do you hope that what should audiences get out of this film?
Well, this is a really important event. This is the assassination of a great president, a great leader, and I think Americans will get a better understanding of why Lincoln was assassinated and that there was a conspiracy to murder him. And it's great entertainment. Okay?
Great. Well, thank you so much.
You're very welcome.
It's not justice you're after, it's revenge.
I would never go to such lengths out of vengeance. But To ensure the survival of this nation, I would do anything. Mary Surratt was a party to the most grievous crime in our history. Necessity demands that she be given a swift, sure, and harsh sentence. I, too, hold sacred our rights, Counselor. But they count not at all if our nation ceases to exist.
I wanted to ask you, what compelled you that the role that you took?
I thought it was a great story.
Yeah, all that stuff that actors have, that is a great story, good script, good role.
And of course, overwhelmingly, the interpretation to what
we've read about it.
What was it like actually working on it? At first, it was slightly intimidating.
Most about the story, about the specifically the conspiracy the assassination.
It's a good story, and I felt that although people know the kind of main story about John Wilkes Booth, they don't know the kind of way in which, you know, there was a real backlash against anybody in any way connected. I think the story is a good story. There's an element of vindictiveness about it, which he doesn't know about.
I have to ask you, what are your thoughts on Joseph Gordon-Levitt potentially playing the son of the character that you're portraying in Batman Begins with Christopher Nolan?
I didn't know that was happening. I don't know who you're talking about. And I'm very happy for the young man.
Might we be seeing a slight cameo, like a flashback in the new film? From your character?
I don't think so. I doubt it. If you find anything out, let me know.
And what was it like working with George Clooney and Michael Clayton?
Great. He's a great guy. Very, very nice guy. Very bright. Feet on the ground. You know, everything you'd expect. Well, not everything you'd expect.
Did you, when you were nominated for Michael Clayton, what was that feeling? I mean, did things change for you in Hollywood? Or?
Oh, no, really. I mean, it wasn't the first time I've been nominated. No, it was just a nice feeling. I felt it was a reward for what I thought was a very intelligent movie. Tony Gilroy wrote and directed it, and George was in there. I thought both of them were fantastic.
Well, the situation is great to be part of such a fantastic project.
Finally, I'm wondering, what can we expect you in
there? Well, that you'll see. Go inside. I don't know. There's a movie coming out called The Debt, which is scheduled for later on this year. I don't know. They never tell me about it. I can never remember what
since I made it.
Well, great. Thank you very much for coming down.
It's a pleasure. Thank you.
It was nice to meet you.
Great.
Thanks.
That was Bill Ayers reporting here with exclusive footage for Real Film News with Tom Wilkinson.
I do like to tell American stories. Yeah. I mean, to me, it's all about a story well told. I mean, you want to tell a story well. I think you owe that to an audience. Storytelling is a big part of my life. It's really about a mother's love for her son, because her sacrifice of herself, her stubbornness, and her feistiness really has to do with protecting her son. That interested me, the emotionality of that. What has always interested me is what's the story beneath the story you think you know? Story within a story. And that's what this had.